All right, I know you guys are thinking, the answer is yes, I can go on roller coasters. I'm what society labels as a bisexual. I'm an existentialist, I don't believe in labels. I prefer to tell people that I'm half gay. People ask me all the time, what do you like better, men or women? But really, they both suck. If they're doing it right. It's hard to date in LA. Lesbians won't date me. They're afraid I'll leave them for a dude. Dudes will only date me because they think they can get a three-way out of it. Right? Like, you gotta be like at least an 8 on a scale of 1 to 10 to ask a girl that at a bar randomly and get away with it. You'd be like a 7 if the girl's your friend, or 4 if you're at a wedding. Generally speaking, I feel like the rule should be 8 because we live in a city. It's hard to date in a city when you're horny. It's like going grocery shopping when you're hungry. You're gonna make bad decisions. We've all done it. We've all left the house a little too high, a little too late at night, woken up the next morning, found a stack of Lunchables in our bed. Like, who bought all these Lunchables? Who's gonna eat these? You didn't get the good kind? You didn't get the kind with the Capri Sun and the Snickers? You got the cheese and cracker ones because you had too much wine. You were feeling fancy. Now you gotta roll another blunt and eat those things. You're gonna have Lunchables texting you for days trying to Netflix and chill. It's not worth it, you guys. I know what I look like. Okay? It's why it weirds me out when dudes pull up to me when I'm walking home. I was leaving work. I was dressed like in my work uniform, black shirt, black pants. In fact, that night I had on this hat, I was carrying a backpack, an extra pair of shoes. I looked like a 12-year-old homeless boy. Some guy pulled up to me anyway. He was like, hey girl, can I help you out with a ride? I was like, no thanks, I'm good. I kept walking. But he revved up. He was like, are you sure? I was like, yep, I'm positive. I continue on about my way. Because I'm sure this guy is a really nice guy just trying to give me a ride home. Right? The thing is, what I heard was, hey girl, want to get raped? No thanks, I'm good. Are you sure? Yep, I'm positive. Continue on about my way. And as I'm almost home, he pulls up a third time. True story, this time with candy. He says, are you sure I can't help you change your mind? I'll be honest, I was scared. I was right next to my house and he had Snickers bars. How did he know that's my favorite candy? Naturally, I told him to fuck off. I figure if I'm gonna get raped and murdered, I should go out fighting. He just got butthurt. He's like, I'm just trying to help you make some money. And then he drove away. Right? I was like, damn it, I like money. I need that shit. I'm poor. So poor I had to give up cocaine. I'm kidding. It came down to that, and if I wanted to feel awesome for 5 minutes, regret and shame for the next 15, I'd just masturbate. It's so much cheaper. All right, that's my time. Thank you, guys.